Okay, so here we are. It's been a long time coming. Almost 2 years, you know, when I started this, when I had this idea to redesign the Blackmagic cinema camera. Here she is. I don't know what to say. It's been amazing. I did a lot of trade work to get the 3D body printed without me having to pay for it. So I made a commercial for the company who printed the camera, and so we kind of, it was a really good deal. And then I also, the first design that I did, you've probably seen if you followed the forum, was very boxy. It looked like a big box. So I actually did some more trade work with an actual 3D designer, and he helped me redesign the camera to what it is now, which looks a lot better. And we have vents on the top and the bottom, our ventilation holes, and then also some on the side. And that's pretty much it. So you have the touch panel on the side here, which actually I've been shooting a short film, and it comes in handy more often than you would think to have it on the side here, a nice monitor on the side. I mean, from everything from the person pulling focus to, you know, the first assistant pulling focus to director just looking at the shot from the side, it comes in handy quite a bit. And then I have on the top two HDMI. I just split the signal from inside the camera. I have my V-mount battery plate. I did this crazy invention thing here. I wanted to power the monitor separately with its own battery, so I wasn't draining the battery from the camera, just to get maximum time from the battery. So I used their little power cable and I cut that and I put it into something that fit that I had. And I made this crazy little thing here, so it goes into the barrel here, and then it actually comes out as a USB cable and plugs into a USB power, like a cell phone power. It's kind of silly, but actually it works really well, and it charges, or it powers the monitor for hours. So it's just like a little cell phone screen, you're kind of similar. So it works out really well, but this is the camera. It works, everything works great. Like I said, I've been shooting quite a bit with it already. The SSD goes into the side here. And yeah, it's a pretty solid design. It's a lot more robust than you would think, at least when I first thought of 3D printing. I was kind of, didn't want to do it. I just wanted something more robust. And granted, yeah, I could go with something more robust in the future, but for now, this is great. It's been really, really good. So I want to get a bigger cheese plate soon that I can put over the whole top of here. It's a little more sturdy. This one's not really made for this kind of stuff. I kind of just hacked one together, but yeah, it's the same, you know, Blackmagic cinema camera. The footage is the same. It didn't change a whole lot, except for, you know, the FPGA, the big processor, is now much farther away from the sensor, so it doesn't get as hot as quickly, which is nice. And I'm working with a few other people in the blog. Saba, I think you may know him if you follow him on the blog and the Blackmagic cinema camera, or the Blackmagic forum, to see if we could find a way to cool the camera even further by, you know, controlling the Peltier device on the sensor manually, so through like another power source. Right now it's running very weak. And it could receive a little more juice to perhaps cool the sensor a little further. and reduce the noise. So, I don't know. Those are a few things. But yeah, that's the camera. And it's been a crazy journey, and I'm really happy it's over and I can actually use it and shoot with it. So, but yeah, if you have any questions, just leave a comment below or just send me a message. And yeah, I'll try to get back to you. Thank you. Take care.